out there know what a cooling tower does? How many out there know what Legionnaires disease is? How many out there know how you catch Legionnaires disease? Christy, would you explain a little bit about what's going on with this cooling tower, what's coming out the top, and what this image is indicating?
Well, actually, cooling towers are predominant on large buildings, hospitals, large shopping centers, things like that.
Schools,
yes. Mm-hmm.
Stadiums,
and anything that is a large building that needs air conditioning. As we saw in New York City, whenever we go there, huge amount of cooling towers on there because air conditioning is important. Well, what you see in this picture is the fan that is pushing off the aerosolized water, or basically the excess, and that water becomes aerosolized water droplets, which if there is Legionnaires bacteria in the water, that aerosolized water droplets can be breathed in by humans, and it actually attacks the lung tissue of humans and causes pneumonia.
Yeah. And that's the only way to catch Legionnaires' disease is by inhaling those aerosolized droplets.
It is. The number one cause of outbreaks are cooling towers.
For Legionnaires' disease.
And so, obviously, since 1976, where the Legionnaires' Convention, this is what the disease is named after, the Legionnaires' Convention of 1976 in Philadelphia, since that occurred, the CDC's kind of been tracking this, and this shows in 2000, there were,
0.5 per 100,000.
Now, in 2017, which is the latest
data
that was available from the CDC, we had 2.5 per 100,000. That is a huge growth.
Wow.
Now, in 2015, the largest outbreak as of 2017 occurred, and there were 128 people infected, 12 of them died. Now,
tell us a little bit about that. Where was that and what happened?
That was actually in the Bronx. And this is kind of interesting because in the South Bronx, it wasn't just an issue of a cooling tower becoming infected. This was actually a kind of a geographical issue here because a cooling tower became infected, but then it infected another one.
So are you telling me the cooling towers were getting each other sick?
Yes, basically, like we are quarantined right now and we had the social distancing. Well, that's not really possible with the cooling towers. They were actually infecting one another, much like we as people are infecting one another with a virus.
Right.
But this is a bacterial infection. And that earlier picture you showed with the cooling tower and the vaporizing mist that rises up, right?
Mm-hmm.
Well, that mist is able to travel miles.
Well, I can see that here, and look at how close the buildings are. So this mist is what infects other cooling towers as well as people.
Right. I'm sorry, meters, not miles, but meters.
Yeah.
And so if you can see in that picture, that mist, that vaporized water can actually travel. Not only does it travel away, but it also falls down. So that water vapor falls down and can actually be sucked back into the fresh air intake of that building.
Of these buildings, right. Got it.
And also the buildings around it.
Right.
So it falls down, it reinfects that building, and it also goes into the air conditioning system, infecting the people in that building, the people on the street, and then the buildings around it. So as you can see, there's two cooling towers there. So one may be infected with Legionnaires, but not the other. But now...
Both of them. Wow.
Now, any buildings adjoining those that are nearby enough to become infected, well, so now we have buildings infecting one another.